Radio frequency identification. Fundamental ideas and principles concerning RFID. Written by Owen Jones. Narrated by Kalila Blake. Published by Teak Time. Welcome to Radio Frequency Identification, Fundamental Ideas and Principles Concerning RFID. In this comprehensive guide, we delve into the world of radio frequency identification, RFID technology, exploring its fundamental concepts, practical applications, and considerations for implementation. RFID technology has emerged as a transformative force, revolutionizing industries ranging from retail and logistics to healthcare and manufacturing. Its ability to track and identify objects wirelessly has paved the way for enhanced efficiency, improved operational visibility, and streamlined processes. However, with these advancements come important considerations regarding privacy, security, and best practices for implementation. In this manual, we aim to provide readers with a clear understanding of RFID technology, its capabilities, and its implications in both business and consumer sectors. From exploring the basics of RFID chips and tags to discussing advanced applications such as asset management and supply chain optimization, we cover a wide range of topics to equip readers with the knowledge needed to navigate the RFID landscape effectively. Additionally, we address key privacy and security concerns associated with RFID technology, offering insights into best practices for safeguarding sensitive information and ensuring compliance with regulatory requirements. By implementing robust privacy measures and security protocols, businesses and consumers can harness the benefits of RFID technology while protecting individual privacy rights and maintaining trust in the digital age. Whether you're new to RFID or seeking to deepen your understanding of its practical applications and implications, this manual serves as a comprehensive resource for navigating the world of radio frequency identification. Join us as we explore the potential of RFID technology and discover how it is shaping the future of business and innovation. I hope that you will find the information helpful, useful, and profitable. The information in this book on various aspects of RFID and related subjects is organized into 21 chapters of about 500 to 600 words each. I hope that it will interest farmers, those who have a young family, or those who are interested in tracking their possessions by radio. If you have any feedback, please leave it with the company you brought this book from. Thanks again for your interest in this book. Regards, Owen Jones. Chapter 1, RFID Chips. RFID, Radio Frequency Identification, chips or tags as they are better known, are the size of the smallest coin in your pocket. But they can hold huge amounts of data that can be used in methods that can do fantastic things. For instance, RFID tags are in the majority of office identity tags and in some passports, allowing the holder to pass through security quickly while keeping the building or the country safe. They are a modern form of the barcode. Remember before barcodes and barcode readers? When a shop assistant had to type prices into the cash register, correct errors, and look up prices that they could not remember. People do not have the time for that anymore. It is all right at the news agents, but imagine a teenager typing in your two trolleys of weekly shopping at the supermarket every Saturday. You would still be there on Sunday. Superstores had thousands of articles and dozens of special offers. No one could remember that lot. No one could, but barcodes make it simple and so do RFID tags. Barcodes work well, but they have to be seen to be read. RFID tags emit their data on a unique frequency which can be read out of line of sight. In other words, an RFID scanner does not need to be able to see the tag to read it. The scanner can read what is in your trolley without you having to unload it, and as you pass by that scanner and pay for your things, they are deducted from stock straight away so that the store manager can see what people are buying and what nobody wishes to buy. So, if one brand of cat food is selling better than another, the manager will see that on the computer printout and buy more of that brand, thereby keeping more people happy. The use of RFID and stock control or asset management, to give it its more formal title, can translate itself into other uses as well. An RFID tag can be put under your cat's fur or in its collar so that you can find him if he gets lost. The police and the warden scan stray animals for a tag as part of their routine these days. Zoologists have been doing this with their wild elephants, tigers, and other threatened species for years. Now you can have it done with your pets also. Company vehicles, as assets of the firm, often have RFID tags, and you can have one put in your car to aid recovery if it is stolen. Baggage handlers at airports or bus terminals can, and do, use them to avoid mislaying luggage. The U.S. government requires RFID tags to be used on all vehicles carrying ammunition or dangerous substances and have done for nearly 10 years. The U.S. military is in fact the biggest user of these tags in the world. RFID tags are used to track military assets such as armaments, battle tanks, fuel, containers, guns, you name it. Some people are anxious about RFID technology. Where is the line between their convenience and their personal information? For instance, they do not like getting junk emails from people that have been able to trace the purchases they made with their credit cards.
Chapter 2, RFID tags in general. All RFID tags are used to store and ultimately send information for asset tracking such as clothing and other items. They can best be thought of as the successor to the barcode. However, they have more important advantages over barcodes. For instance, RFID tags or RFID chips can store much more information than barcodes. They can be scanned from further away and they can actually send data, not only store data. There are three types of RFID tags: passive, active, and hybrid. Passive RFID tags are the least expensive because they employ less complex technology. They have to be induced to divulge their information by borrowing power from an RFID reader. When the reader's radio waves hit them, they echo back their information if they are within range. These are the kinds of tags and smart labels used in goods in a retail outlet or on boxes in a warehouse to track inventory. On the other hand, active RFID tags have a battery, a transmitter, and an antenna so that they are always sending. These devices are obviously a lot more expensive and so are used only on more costly items such as containers, battle tanks, aircraft, on criminal ankle bands.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.